What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Soft Cell. And we're going back to the 1983 album, The Art of Falling Apart. See if I can move my kitten without making her fall apart mentally. I think she's all good. But yeah, we're going to listen to Numbers, which it's a single word title. Those do tend to be a tough to get a read on. But I'm intrigued because, you know, without any context for what the numbers relate to, they're just abstractions, right? Like, numbers and math, they can represent real entities, ontological reality, but without a referent, they're just abstractions. They're just pure logic. So, I'm curious the way in which numbers will be relevant. Given a lot of their themes, it's still hard to get a sense of what might be happening here. So let's find out. This is Soft Cell. The tune is Numbers, and it's from their 1983 album, The Art of Falling Apart.
Numbers. Who's the person that you woke up next to today? If you were
like phone numbers, owner,
then you know you'd have to pay your way. Well, maybe you do already, but you make out they pay you.
So we're talking
Did
money?
You ask yourself, what did life go wrong with you? Because when I say goodbye, a silly thing happens, and I always cry.
God, I love that. I don't know what that... It's either like cannon fire or a
Numbers.
Something rattling around.
You're looking so thin these days, are you doing speed?
No, Numbers.
Have you seen your face? Now you're really gone to see. Real and there's no real people in these games.
It's weird, like that one part, it changes the vibe. The rest of the track is sort of, it's a bit funky, but it's angry, it's edgy. But then that synth, thoughtful, reflective. I like this xylophone. And the birds. I haven't commented on the birds, but...
Body 2, body 3, body body four, body one, body two.
Not a full person, at least to the other person.
Sonic brew. It's like some disparate elements put together, although again most of it had this bristling, edgy, a bit brooding kind of feel to it, but then that one woodwind flute-esque synth really gave it a different dimension and really made it a bit more reflective and thoughtful. So again, by the end it seems pretty clear we're talking just numbers, as in like people, bodies, literally just people who come into your life for a hot minute but don't end up being significant, or don't end up being someone that you want to keep seeing, or that you want to be anything more than what that was. So yeah, it feels like a song from someone who's jaded, someone who knows the sort of what's the superficiality of these experiences that he's having, but can't seem to get himself out of this loop, out of this life. So yeah, it feels like there's a lot of pain there and a lot of frustration, but also like a resignment, is that a word? Someone being resigned toward their disposition, toward this life. So yeah, it feels like they're trapped and they don't want to be, but again, it doesn't seem like there's any change on the horizon. It's just a comment on the state and the condition that they are in, living this life where there's just bodies. But I do enjoy the flip of it, right? Because you're thinking of it from the point of view of the narrator, and it's, you know, all these other people, it's you know, they don't really matter to me as full, complete people in of themselves. They're just, you know, body one, body two, body three, you know, four or five in a day, whatever. But then you find out one at some point that you're just a body to somebody else. You know, you thought, oh, this person's actually cool and we'll have a good connection. Oh, they don't care about me. They don't want to call me back. Like, it literally, I was just one more experience in their running body count. So I enjoyed the way it flipped, and the narrator realizes, you know, at some point in people's lives, everybody realizes they are just one body to somebody else. So yeah, I did enjoy the flip aspect there. I heard going into this album from a couple different people that sort of the tensions and the attitudes and frustrations that dominate some of their themes and their music were, I guess, coming to a head at this point. So, you know, you hear a song like this and it's like, damn, like, it feels like this is just them, you know, putting themselves out in the open, just, you know, being very vulnerable in the sense that, you know, this is the kind of life I'm living and this is the psychology that I have. So turns out, you know, as it seems, they weren't kidding. It wasn't something that was done for style or whatever. It's like they were really writing songs about the place they were at emotionally and psychologically. So in any case, really cool tune, and I'm interested to hear if this album continues sonically in the way it has, in the sense that I'm enjoying it. It definitely sounds a bit different from Nonstop Ecstatic Dancing, or Nonstop Erotic Cabaret, and Nonstop Ecstatic Dancing for that matter. But yeah, I'm getting a different sonic atmosphere so far on this album compared to the first studio album. So let me know if you agree, let me know what you think of this tune in general, and Luca, the completely comatose cat, and I will see you next time. Peace.